Outdoorsman James Flynn sets out on a camping trip into the Florida Everglades. Looking for his dogs lost deep in the swamp, he encounters a strange flying object.
At this point, James is actually in disbelief. He really doesn't know what's going on, so he heads towards this object. It's very hostile, and it's an extreme environment. You have what's called sawgrass that's sometimes impassable.
He gets as close as he can, gets about 200 yards away, and the thing settles down. It's all lit up.
Flynn approaches the edge of a clearing in the swamp.
Finally, he's going to have a clear look at this object.
He's confronted with this unusual cone-shaped object. The orange light that he saw originally was now coming from the bottom of the craft, illuminating the ground.
As he gets in a little closer, he's seeing what looked like riveted panels all over this thing.
And then there was a deafening ringing sound that came from it. Now there's a wind or a force or something that comes from the object and makes it difficult even to stand up.
Possibly the wind was a byproduct of whatever the force was that was keeping it from the ground.
Some say this can be a Harrier jump jet, which can hover in place. However, Harrier jump jets aren't in the shape of a cone. They don't put an orange light out from the bottom. They just don't match anything that Flynn reported. Despite the blast of wind, or whatever it was, Flynn keeps walking toward the object and decides to try to make communication with it by waving his arm. He hears a large whooshing sound, which he thinks might be the craft departing.
Suddenly, this beam of light shoots straight out of the craft, hits him in the forehead, just over his right eye.
Flynn was knocked to the ground, immediately felt pain.
He described it as like getting hit by a sledgehammer. And at that point, James Flynn lost consciousness. When James Flynn came to, he was actually physically blind. It was literally a physical blindness from whatever hit him in the forehead.
After a few minutes, he begins to regain some sight, mostly in his left eye.
He had been basically unconscious for 12 or 14 hours.
He looks around and sees that the UFO, the craft, is gone.
He noticed the area where this craft was. There was burned out locations of grass, vegetation, and scuffed trees.
That's what stands out about this one. Sure, it's a single witness case, but Flynn had injuries that were verified by medical doctors and consistent with his testimony.
Flynn gathers his dogs and leaves the swamp to seek medical help. Doctors find that Flynn has impaired sight, swollen eyelids, and an abrasion on his forehead. Flynn also fails a tendon reflex test, suggesting possible damage in the nerve connections between his spinal cord and muscles. As he recovers in hospital, Flynn is visited by Air Force officials. Despite promises of an investigation, none is ever conducted. James returns to the site of his encounter with four locals. They find the burn marks still visible on the ground. The group takes photos of the marks as well as soil samples. They later send this material to the Air Force, but never hear back. James eventually recovers his reflexes and his sight in one eye, but the other remains permanently impaired.